Christmas on BBC One.
Who are you?
Horror in Poltergeist 2.
Let me in.
What do you want me to do? Who is it?
Tell me what the feel.
Why the hell won't you leave us alone?
You are gonna die.
Poltergeist 2, Boxing Day at 10:25 on BBC One.
On BBC Two Wales at midnight tonight, Beverly Anderson invites her guests to look behind the headlines in another half an hour of discussion and debate. That's behind the headlines in just over 5 minutes. Let's look at some of the stories now that have been making headlines in Wales today. Dyfed Powys police are hunting two young men with English accents after an attempted armed robbery at the Manodalo post office. One of the men struggled with the post office mistress Eunice Davis when he tried to force a door into the counter area. The other waved a gun at her 11-year-old grandson, who ran into the post office after hearing Mrs. Davis shouting for help. A 36-year-old local man has appeared before Cardiff magistrates accused of the murder of 63-year-old Jeremiah Dacey. Shane Johnson, who lived in the same house, was remanded in custody. The Labour MP for Swansea West, Alan Williams, has criticised the government for refusing to promise extra money to cut the number of prison suicides. But he welcomes a report which makes more than 100 recommendations. Politicians have reacted angrily to the news that the Welsh National Opera is considering redundancies or closure because of a cash crisis. The chairman of the Welsh Development Agency, Dr. Gwyn Jones, says the WNO should find further sponsorship to fund productions. A man has been jailed for life for raping a 9-year-old Welsh holidaymaker after dragging her from a tent at a caravan park in West Sussex. Brett Jones from Berkshire pleaded guilty at Lewis Crown Court. And finally, Rumney Valley Council has revealed that the new owners of the Euromet toxic waste depot in Rumney are to clear the site. Work on the clearation will start after Christmas. And those are tonight's News of Wales headlines. Now, tomorrow morning on Radio Wales, Peter Johnson is on air with Weekday Wales at 7 o'clock, looking forward and looking back. He'll be asking whether Britain's special relationship with the United States will continue to flourish as Britain's new Prime Minister meets President Bush for the first time this weekend at Camp David. And looking back, the BBC's Welsh political correspondent does just that on the day that Parliament breaks up for the Christmas recess, reviewing the past year in Welsh politics. Those two stories and the rest of the day's news agenda on air tomorrow morning with Peter, 7 o'clock sharp. Brief look at the weather for the next 24 hours. Tonight, as you can see, some sleet and rain, minimum temperatures around 1 degree Celsius. Tomorrow, some rain at first, brightening up later, an improving day all round, maximum temperatures lying at around 7 Celsius. The weather forecast for Wales for the next 24 hours. An announcement now for viewers using the Trevilian and Brecon stations. On Thursday, the 20th of December, all television services from Trevilian will be off the air from 9:15 in the morning till 12:30 in the afternoon. That's 9:15 till 12:30 midday. This is to enable South Wales Electricity to carry out essential maintenance work. Also tomorrow, all television services from Brecon and its dependent relay stations will be off the air between 9 in the morning and 12 midday. Again, this is to enable the Electricity Board, South Wales Electricity, to carry out essential maintenance. We apologise in advance for any inconvenience that this may cause. Well, that's it for Wednesday here on BBC One Wales. There is no more. Before I let you go, at a fraction after 3 minutes to midnight, all I'll do is to bid you a sound and peaceful night, remind you that BBC Breakfast News is on air here at 6:30. If you're joining us for that, better to get off to sleep quickly. If not, we look forward to your company at some stage throughout the day. But for now, from me and all my colleagues, a very good night to you. North Star.